Alrighty. So this is going to be a reading for my Leos for November 2019. This is going to be a who's coming towards you forecast, okay? So definitely keep in mind this is going to be a general message. So everything I say may or may not pertain to you specifically. Definitely make sure you're using a level of discernment on what messages are for you, because some of them just may be for another person watching this, since it's so many people viewing these messages, okay? If you are someone who does want a personal reading with me, all of that information will be listed below in the description box as well as the comment section for you. And that's also where you, on my website, you can also buy intention oils, crystal healing jewelry, and whatnot. So definitely check that out if you are interested, okay? Everything will be below. So what's going on with my Leos for November 2019, please? What is the energy surrounding my Leos for that time frame? This is a new deck, guys. I'm trying to break it in, so bear with me. Hold on. Bear with me. All right, Leos. Okay, so let's go ahead and get into it. I'm sorry. So the first thing I'm going to cover, Leos, is going to be the energy of who's coming towards you, okay? And what we have representing that, I do have pay attention to the red flags, and I also have the Page of Pentacles. So the person that you're possibly having come towards you in the month of November may be an earth sign, a Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. This person may be a little immature. I'm going to be honest with you as far as not being at the place where they want to be. When I say immature, I don't mean like they're childish. I mean, they're not at the place to where they need to be in life, or when it comes to offering something in a relationship sense, they may not have much to offer in that sense, but being there, or, you know, just giving you the idea of it being a stable relationship. And for a lot of you, you may need to pay attention to those red flags that this person is not living up to those expectations that you're putting onto them. Whether that's you thinking this person's going to evolve into something that's, this person evolving into something that's going to be more stable. For some of you, this is like a friends with benefits type of situation. It's not even a committed relationship. And there may be a need for you to see things for what it is with this, instead of placing expectations on someone that can't really be that, if that makes sense. Clarifying this Page of Pentacles, I also have the Eight of Cups. Like I said, there's somebody that you guys are dealing with who, it's like the idea of them being somebody stable makes you feel good, but it's like they're not doing that. Or when it comes to just them having their shit together, you may be realizing, oh man, this person really does not have their shit together. Okay, and this is going to put you in a space of either worrying about this connection when you walk away, or for some of you, a Page of Pentacles may have walked away from a connection with you, and you could be overthinking things. All right? But beyond this, when it comes to their feelings for you, I do have Let Your Friends Help You, and it's clarified by the Justice card. So I feel like this person has been trying to get some advice from other people around them, whether that's close family members or friends, or whoever they have been talking to. That's what I'm trying to say. Excuse me. I'm getting tongue-tied. I've been doing a lot of readings today, okay? Don't come for me in the comments, all right? But what I'm seeing with this person, they've been asking other people for advice on what to do with this situation. And it's like they're torn between the two. It's like, can we actually make this thing work? Can we fix things? Or do I need to just let this go? Should I just, you know, chump this up as a loss? Should I just, you know, move forward with my own peace of mind and let this be? But it's like this person still kind of has this glimmer of hope for you guys to become something. So it's like they really are trying to get guidance on which way to move with this. And they also, I feel like this person does want to be fair with their approach towards you when it comes to like asking for another chance or something of that sort. It's just, they may feel like, okay, this relationship may be pretty done. or there's just certain aspects of the relationship that need to be done, whether that's toxicity, so that there could be more balance here. Now, when it comes to the actions that your person is going to take towards you, I do have the attraction card as well as the Eight of Swords. So I feel like this person is still going to be very much stuck on you, Leos. This person is going to be in a whirlwind of trying to figure out what the hell to do with this situation. They may feel like their hands are tied with this, like, oh, they don't know exactly what to do, but they know what to do. It's just they don't know how to approach you about this situation. They also emotionally can't sort out their feelings. They're like torn between the two. Or not torn between the two. They're torn between all these different emotions, and they're really needing to sort out what they want to do moving forward. So I don't feel like they're going to take much action towards you this month if you guys have stopped speaking to each other, or there may be like some sort of break in place. I don't feel like there's going to be any immediate action. This is going to be after they come out of a space of being confused emotionally. All right. Now, when it comes to the advice I can give you, Leos, I do have finances and career and the Six of Swords. And with this, for a lot of you, you really need to focus on your money endeavors and getting your career in order. For a lot of you, you could be struggling in that arena. Or for some of you, you could be getting better in that arena as far as like new opportunities coming your way and whatnot. And there may be a need for you to tend to those because that may be more promising than what you're experiencing in your love life. Clarifying that, I do have the Six of Swords and the Nine of Wands. So yeah, there's a need for you to also mentally move on from situations that have been leaving you in a space of just being at your wit's end almost, and just really having to deal with defensive ass people for some of you. And you're really just going to have to decide, like, look, am I just going to move on from the situation completely? For some of you, you may even want to move states to completely forget about this relationship if it has been that serious. And some of you need to decide whether or not you're going to stick it through, even though you're already pretty much at your breaking point. Now, when it comes to the obstacle that may come up this month, I do have religious factors and the Queen of Swords. So who you guys are romantically interested in may not have the same beliefs as you, whether this is your spiritual and this person does not believe any of that stuff, or this person's more religious and you're not into that, or this person's atheist and you may not understand why this person doesn't have any belief system. For others of you, you just have different viewpoints on how you see the world. This person may see the world from a very like negative perspective. You may see it from a more positive perspective or a more spiritual nature, and they just may see the world as just very blah, whatever it may be. There also may be some religious differences as far as interracial relationship where, you know, one person's a different race than the other person, or ethnicity, I should say, whatever it may be, or even a same-sex relationship. But that may be causing an issue this month. Also, with the Two of Pentacles and the Queen of Swords, this could be instability as far as like the relationship being up and down, up and down. One second you guys are on good terms, the next second things are just not in the best of places. And with it being clarified by the Queen of Swords, I'm just getting a sense that the issue is also communication, speaking your mind, or this person feeling like, you know, speaking their mind may be a level of an issue, or even just being clear on certain things and just having clarity as well, or even making a decision when it comes to what the hell you're going to do with someone. Because it's like, again, you just go back and forth, and a lot of you, you can't move on from some disappointments that happened in the past, or you just feel disappointed overall. And this could be, you know, taking a toll on you this month. But the final advice I can give you when it comes to your love life this month, Leos, I do have playfulness, and it says laughter is the best therapy. Have some fun together and remember love is the greatest healer. And then I also have beware of what you're projecting, for the qualities you admire in one another are qualities you both possess. Equally so, the qualities you don't like are also your own reflection. So there's definitely a need for you to put yourself out there to enjoy life and not be so serious, especially if you are feeling, you know, down by certain things that may be taking place within your love life. I don't feel like you should stop yourself from enjoying your life, stop yourself from being in the flow of what the universe has in store for you by being upset or being sad or being, you know, in this state of regret. And also, when it comes to whoever you may be dealing with in a love sense, there's a need for you to make sure the qualities that you are, you know, repulsed by in them, whether that's like, you know, whatever it may be, I'm not even going to go down the list, but whatever qualities you don't too much care for in that person, and even the things that you do care about or you do like about this person, there's a need for you to understand, why do you feel some sort of resonation, or why do you resonate with certain things that this person may do, or why do you not kind of like that? Understand where it's stemming from, because it may be your own personal experiences that may make you think that way, or are making you look at the situation the way that you are. I hope that makes sense. Okay, I sound kind of whatever right now, okay? But I'm gonna end the reading here. Thank you so much, Leos, for watching this. I really hope that you enjoyed this reading. If you did, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe. And again, if you do want a personal session with me, I do have like a 30-minute special going on. 30-minute special going on where you can get it for $25 instead of $55. So if you are interested in that, definitely make sure you book your sessions below before that's over, honey. And yeah, I will see you guys in the next one. Bye, Leos.